National Workers Union here at the Constantine Recreation Ground with Comrade Glen Ramjag and Comrade Farouk, Deonarine, organizers of the annual blocker cricket competition. What is noticeable this year is that the venue has been changed. There has been a very odd date for the staging of the competition, given that school will be closing in 2 days, and also there seems to be less teams taking part this year. So could you all give us what caused these changes this year in the competition? Could you all tell us, please?
Well, the first thing is that, remember, every year, this competition is for students who sit, what was the common entrance then, and then the SEA. This exam used to finish usually sometimes late March, sometimes very early April, and we would start immediately after. Now, with the change of the date of the SEA exam to somewhere, when it was?
May the 14th.
It meant that we had much less time. Now, remember, we run a league, we run a big eight, and we run a knockout champions competition. It's three competitions we run.
And the girls.
And we also have the girls league. Right? So we had much less time. We had a month and a half less to run the whole competition. So Farouk and I had a discussion. We said, boy, you know, we are short time. I think we go out to improvise, we go out to, but we have to run this competition. And we say, yeah, we're going ahead with it. And actually, from the reports you have heard, is that the Block Up is one of the few, if not the only, sporting organization that has run things such as after SCA. That actually engaged the thing. A lot of people just drop off and, you know, became despondent. And we say, nah, we have to improvise, we have to come up with this obstacle, we have to run this thing. Because all these three are dependent on us. All these schools dependent on us. We have a true partnership between the Block Up, which is the sporting organization that organize and taught all this thing, and the schools, the principals of the schools, the teachers, and the parent teacher association, the teachers who are coaches of the schools, who coach it in. This is a very keen competition going on here 29 years, you know, and these people form the committee that run the thing. Now, it affected us in many ways besides the time. Then there were everybody keen and started to get involved in the competition. Some schools had to drop off after they played two or three games because the teachers had to do the CAC training. And we had examples of teams crying and teachers and coaches crying because they couldn't participate. Some of them played two games and they had to drop out. So, but we did have 28 schools from the boys participating. We managed to, you know, 28 of them completed all the games and so on. But
what is the likelihood of going back to a more suitable date?
Well, based on the reports we have had and how we ran it and so on, we have to talk to the officials and we have to see, well, what could happen, because people are still expressing reservations about next year, which is our 30th year, and we have big plans for that. So we have to talk to them and see, well, what could happen with it, because having a little more time and also in terms of having the schools mobilized to train, because all these schools have coaches, you know. This is a very keen thing. You can see the level of the play is very high, even at this level. You know, so we have some groundwork we need to do. We have some meetings to make, where things that we took for granted for the last 29 years, we now have to, you know, have a re-look at it.
The time factor is a crucial thing. Besides the month and two weeks we have to pull off this tournament. After the tournament, during the tournament, the Ministry of Education organized a workshop called CAC, and most of the teachers who were in charge of their teams had to go into the workshop. So some of them was very despondent, some of them was frustrated, some of them decided they ain't going. Most of them went though, because it was a directive from the principals and the Ministry of Education.
What you are saying is extremely interesting, I'll tell you why. One of the new components of this continuous assessment program is co-curricular activity, like sports, physical and all kind of thing. I imagine somebody participating in a blocker competition could be graded on the basis of the participation in the competition.
But we hoping that that will take place. We hoping that this will become a component of it, and we could now come in into the full curriculum and work out some sort of schedule and agenda with the ministry.